to much effect.
Annapolis.
Have they made peace in the last 55 years?
Well, they have tried. They have tried. Clinton came as close as one can imagine.
So Britain has tried too.
Well, not obviously.
Obviously, it doesn't have the same amount of power.
Far less power.
But it's stuck to principles. Your country may not like them, some of the principles, but it's stuck to them.
Tim, this is a very tough area. And in that area, you cannot come only with good ideas. You need to be able to intimidate. Just inspiration without
intimidate.
Yes, inspiration without intimidation will not work.
And would you say that was what your country indulged in?
Well,
intimidation.
Indeed, yes. That's the reality in that part of the world. They don't give a chance to the second chance to the defeated, and they have no mercy on the weak. That's a reality. Now you need. Nobody has, including us. I'm not trying to pass the problem to the others. What I want to say here is that the only way to solve the problem, and not only this particular problem, many other problems, is if you are able to merge soft power with the capacity to twist arms. And only the United States has that capacity.
All right, Shlomo Ben-Ami, thank you very much indeed. Now let me ask, please, Ragida Dergum to speak against the motion.
Yes, I speak against the motion because I think the term terminal decline does not apply to the United Kingdom's policy in the Middle East, influence over the Middle East. That is because it's a matter of choice that the British governments have decided to either exercise that influence in certain measures or not to exercise it at all. When we say terminal decline, that means that the UK has no option. It's outside of their hands. This is not the case. The United Kingdom does have influence. How does it choose to use it? That's another issue. Secondly, I'd like to say that the United Kingdom is and was influencing the region in many different ways. It depends if you want to call it good or bad. I don't think the discussion right now, whether it's good influence or bad influence, basically you could say that the Balfour Promise made 90 years ago that carved out, that promised Israel the state in Palestine, was the legacy of the United Kingdom. That's not a very welcomed legacy in the Arab world or in the Muslim world. The same thing you can say recently in participating in the Iraq war. Some could argue that this was terribly an influential role by the United Kingdom, not a welcomed one by some. Thirdly, on Palestine, Tony Blair is building or helping build institutions. And that is no minor thing. This is an important contribution because this is about building the state of Palestine. And that is a great contribution that the United Kingdom is doing through Tony Blair. Number four, I think Iran is a very important issue where the United Kingdom played a very leading role, I would argue, because they went ahead and were the architect of collective diplomacy. Finally, a couple of things. The UK is not an isolationist country. It has commercial ties, economic ties with the Gulf states. It is quite influential in a very particular way with the EU, who are part of the quartet on the Palestinian issue. And the fact that there is a very special relationship between the United Kingdom and the United States gives the United Kingdom a very special kind of influence. No, the influence of the United Kingdom in the Middle East is certainly not in terminal decline.
Ragida Dergum, thank you very much indeed. You mentioned Britain's influence with the United States. What did it produce?
Well, whatever it has produced in the past, as I said, it could have been negative.
Yeah, but what did it produce?
So far,
is there any evidence that it produced anything at all?
A partnership in the Security Council on resolutions, for example, towards Lebanon. I think that has been a very important collective relationship there.
Well,
on
you
Iran,
mentioned Lebanon, but actually Britain suffered the humiliation of being told by the United Nations to stay out of it. So important was its role in
nevertheless,
Lebanon.
Nevertheless, the UK goes on playing a role within the Security Council in producing the resolutions that are putting Lebanon on the right track with an international consensus, or at least to fight for it. So you can't dismiss the role that they've
done. Give me one example of anyone taking Britain seriously in the Middle East in the last 3 years.
Oh, I would say Iran takes the United Kingdom incredibly seriously.
Really? In what way? Such that they can pinch their soldiers and their sailors off a little barge in the Shatt al-Arab waterway whenever they feel like it. Is that taking Britain seriously?
Yes, they do take Britain seriously, as I said, because there is a political process, a diplomatic process, that if the United Kingdom gives it up, then there is another obvious option for towards Iran, military. And I think the Iranians pay very good attention to how the EU, led by Britain, as I said, the architect through Jack Straw of that collective diplomacy, They pay a lot of attention
to
that.
We spoke to one Arab official before this debate started, and his quote is this: you would have to go back several generations to find anyone in the Arab world who dealt with Britain as a major player. Today, when we pick up the phone at a crucial time, we talk to Washington.
I have another quote from another senior Arab official.
Maybe you'd like to answer that one instead of playing quote games.
This is the quote, yes. We count on the sober analysis and the sober way the British look at issues, in contrast with whimsical political trends that influence others. So I think that's
what... Perhaps you'd like to answer my point first.
I would absolutely differ with that.
All right, okay. Raghada Degham, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Could we ask, please, Baroness Faulkner to speak for the motion now?
Well, I think it's pretty obvious that Britain's role is in decline. We can quip about the word terminal or not, but the decline is there. Both history and current events point to that. A notable historian described Britain's exit from the Middle East in terms of its colonial history as a country that was either kicked out, bowed out, or ran out. Pretty ignominious, I think. And if you look at its recent interventions in the affairs of the region in the last 30 or 40 years, it has not been a player in terms of resolving the conflicts of